Video is going to explore playing with rhythm in Illustrator. It's going to introduce using the rectangle and line shapes. All right, so over in tools, you have your rectangle tool. Down here, you have your fill and your stroke. Your fill is the solid box. If you click on it, it will move to layered on top of your stroke. Here is your stroke. When you click on your fill, the color window shows up over here. So we are going to say show options. You can change your color mode, RGB for screen versus CMYK for print. If you double click on your fill color, it brings up your color picker, and this allows you to select. You can also move through the rainbow, and you'll see your selection stays in the same place, rotating through the hues, or you may select for a different brightness. All right, so we're gonna pick black, which is all the way in the bottom right. Your hex code is all zeros. Say okay. Click on the rectangle. If you hold down shift, it will constrain proportions and will make a square for you. Alternatively, you can double click and a rectangle prompt will come up and you can choose the size. All right, so we're gonna use our alignment tool. So we go to window, align. All right, so if we're looking at our align window, we have a lot of different icons. When you scroll over the icon, it will tell you what it does. So what we're going to do is we're going to align the square to the center of our artboard. I'm using my select tool, which is an arrow, the black arrow. If I click off, you can see it's not selected. If I click to it, it has a blue outline, which means it is selected. So any tools that I use are adjusting this shape. My align to, I have selected align to artboard. So I click my rectangle and I say align objects, horizontal align center. See, it moved it horizontally in my artboard. Then I'm going to vertical align center, and now it's in the center. If I want it larger, I can hold down shift and option and grab from the corner. That keeps the center point in the center and expands it. Alternatively, if I just held down shift, I would still be keeping it a square, but it's pulling just to the right. So when I'm done with that, I would need to vertically and horizontally align center again. All right, now we're gonna work with lines. You can see under your tools, if you click and hold, you'll get a flyout panel. We're gonna use the line segment tool. I'm gonna click and then hold down shift to make it. Oops. Okay, so you're going to click and drag, and I hold down shift to keep it straight. You move your shapes around with your black arrow, your selection tool. All right, you can see you can grab the point on the right and drag it out. You can see it's very easy not to keep it straight. If you hold shift down, it will pop it back to a horizontal straight line. You can do the same things as far as aligning, horizontal, vertical and horizontal alignments. When I have a line selected, you see up at the top, I get additional details about the line. The stroke, I can make it thicker. I can make it thinner. All right, if I want to copy a line, I select it. I can say edit, copy, edit, paste. It pasted it on top, so now I would drag it somewhere else. Another thing is when you're looking, copy, you can see it gives you the key command as Command C and Command V. So I can do Command C, Command V, and now I have another line. Like another thing I can do is while it's selected, I can hold down Option on my Mac keyboard and drag, and it is duplicating it for me. All right, so once you have a variety of lines, we're gonna work on creating movement. So in this one, I'm going to move the eye from the bottom to the top. So I'm gonna have thicker lines at the bottom. So I can go up arrows, or I can select and just choose something. You can also come in and type if you wanted a specific number. All right. Now, if you get to a point where your screen kind of grays out, it means that you've gone in to a containing layer. So look for this kind of breadcrumb up at the top and click back out. And keep clicking out until that disappears and the color comes back to the way that you expect. All right, so I'm gonna lay that there. So I know that one is 35, so now this one I'm gonna do 25. I'm gonna bring it maybe to about here. And then this one, maybe 15. Bring it to about here. Maybe 10. And then we'll leave that one as is. So you can see I've made a pattern from big to thin, right? So thick to thin. We've created movement, and we're playing with negative space and positive space. So that's the goal of this assignment, is where that we're going to start to kind of work on how we can play with positive and negative space. So just as we duplicated a line, we can also duplicate an artboard. So if we click on our artboard icon, we can hold down Option, and you can see my mouse changes to this double arrow, a black and a white arrow. That means it's duplicate. So I can now click and drag, and now I have a copy. And you can see even the artboard has copy in the name. Now I can select more than one item by holding down Shift. So I'm holding down Shift and I can click on each of the lines. Now, if I accidentally click on the black square, you can see I get the bounding box around the square. You can unselect something by clicking on it again. So now I have those, just the lines. They're grouped so I can see this bounding box. And if I put my mouse on a corner, you can see I get a rotation arrow. So I'm gonna rotate these. And if I hold down Shift, it will constrain it to going vertical for me. We'll kind of move it at very specific angles, right? So it will kind of grab it to the closest, like maybe 15 degrees, 30 degrees. All right. So now I've experimented going horizontal as well. So this is an example of using lines. And if I hold down on lines, I can get back to my rectangle and rectangle to create rhythm and start to play with what is foreground and what is background, what's negative space and what's positive space.